Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hey guys, this is Sam Pardee here recording a video for Channel Fireball. We're playing a little more modern today with Melira, doing a little final last-minute testing for Grand Prix Detroit. And this is pretty close to the list I'm pretty sure I'm going to run. So the changes from last time are we've moved down to just one voice in the main because we've added Scavenging Ooze, which is similar to voice in that it's really good in the fair matchups, but it gives you another angle. Like, it can hit on graveyard decks like Gifts Ungiven or whatever people happen to be doing. And then the other big change is we've added Archangel of Thune and Spike Feeder combo. So basically the way that works is Archangel puts a counter on your creatures whenever you gain life. Spike Feeder can remove counters to gain life. You put infinite counters on your creatures and gain infinite life. It's especially nice on Magic Online because it doesn't take that long to execute. To make room for that, we've cut down on Court of Calling, and we removed the second Melira, so we're down to just one Melira, because Archangel also works with Kitchen Finks if you have a sack outlet, because it puts a counter on the Finks when you gain the life, which unpersists it, so you can go infinite that way. And we've also removed a Court of Calling, just because they can be kind of clunky. The sideboard is pretty much the same. Two voices, so you can board up to three total, Lingering Souls, Dismember, pretty much all the usual suspects. So let's get to it. This hand is sketchy, but the payoff is really high, so I'm going to keep it. Basically, if we draw a second land, it's insane. Or if he doesn't kill our Deathrite and we like just play Wall of Roots, it's still pretty good. So I think it's good enough to keep. We'll go get our Overgrown Tomb and Deathrite. Basically, like, the scenarios where if he kills Deathrite, then that sucks. But if he kills Deathrite and we draw a land, then it's not actually that bad. So I think it's worth keeping. I'm going to play the Pod here because that lets us pod away the Wall of Roots for sure next turn if he does something that involves killing our Deathrite. Looks like he's Tron with a really slow, or maybe Scapeshift. Some kind of ramp deck. So now I can play Wall of Roots, and we can pot away the wall or the Deathrite. I'm trying to think of how we want to win this game. I suppose if we pot away Deathrite for Melira next turn, we can play Finks and Cord for Sack Outlet, which should be good. So I'll do that. And it lets us keep the most mana in play, which is not irrelevant. Yeah, we can even pot away the Finks for Redcap and actually kill him next turn. No idea what our opponent's playing. This is a Maelstrom Pulse. Ghost Quartering himself. Okay. Interesting. Alright, so I guess he's a Death Cloud deck, is my best wager. Yeah, some kind of Death Cloud Life from the Loam deck. Not exactly where I would want to be in this format, because Scavenging Ooze is probably really good against him. So we'll gain infinite life and also deal him infinite damage. Seems like not a bad turn four. So he ran pretty well that game. Alright. You didn't even need to see the cord. Sideboarding. I guess Lingering Souls is probably going to be good against him. I don't really know. Shriek Maw seems okay. I'm going to guess Metamorph is not good. He probably has Dark Confidant, so Orzhov Pontiff's probably good. Spellskite and a... Well, I don't know about Abrupt Decay. It kills Deathrite, which is usually important. I think I'm going to take out the Abrupt Decays and bring in Dismembers instead. No, I'll leave in Abrupt Decay. I'll take out Pride Mage. Voices seem like they're probably good. I'll take out a seer. I'm kind of just going to pretend he's Jund and board like that. Which I think this is about my sideboard plan against Jund. I'd bring in the dismembers, but against this guy, I don't think I will. So we'll try this.